apartments with walls that are weak. Sometimes I'd hear it all if my neighbors would speak. But this recent apartment and bedroom that I got started out seeming decent, more boring than not. For 2 or 3 years, nothing happened at all. There was an old man next door that I would see in the hall. He shuffled politely, wears an old suit. You know, a standard old geezer, a quiet old coot. He used to seem normal, but then all at once he started these nocturnal groanings and grunts. It's hard to get used to, it gives me the creeps. Pretty much every night now he screams when he sleeps. Dark night of our souls, dark night of our hearts, dropping down the bottomless hole. I just need to get some sleep, I don't know when I might begin. But I don't want another minute in this same old story, purgatory. Stop the torture, old man, and please don't be myself from the future. If it was a dog bark or a screaming infant, I'd probably be fine, back asleep in an instant. But picture me lying there alone in my bed, when this old man just lets out these shrieks near my head. And now every night at like 3 in the a.m. I get woken up by this miserable mayhem. Who's being dismembered? What the hell is wrong? I'm scared that he'll send me insane before long. And it makes me afraid just to be me like I am, cause it could be my fatal lonely screaming old man. Tell me, what did he do in his youth for this torture? And what if I'm him and it's true that he's me in the future? Dark night of our souls, dark night of our hearts, dropping down the bottomless hole. I just need to get some sleep, I don't know when I might begin. But I don't want another minute in this same old story, purgatory. Stop the torture, old man, and please don't be myself from the future. I'm used to apartments with walls that are weak. Sometimes I'd hear it all if my neighbors would speak. But this recent apartment and bedroom that I got started out seeming decent, more boring than not. But now it's like trying to sleep in a Guantanamo cell block, or a hospital hellhole for some horrible shell shock, or a medieval dungeon with sadistic conditions where some pitiful someone is getting whipped while you listen. And you know, in the dark when your mind is just spinning and you get visions of weird things with no ends or beginnings, I drift off for a bit and then he's screaming some more. And I'm scared that he's me and I'm the him from before. I get some paranoid fantasy sci-fi scenarios. They seem dumb in the daylight, but for now again there he goes. Dark night of our souls, dark night of our hearts, dropping down the bottomless hole. I just need to get some sleep, I don't know when I might begin. But I don't want another minute in the same old story, purgatory. Stop the torture, old man, and please don't be myself from the future.
Well, you know, Jeffrey, it's true what you say. I once was like you, but then I turned out this way. I lived my own life complaining love wasn't there. It was never enough to sacrifice for or care. And